Good morning, students. Let's start with the next chapter, that is fun with magnets. You all know about magnet and what is the property of magnet. You all have seen that a magnet attracts iron objects towards itself. So first we'll move on to the history of magnet. Now it's a small story that once long time ago in northern Greece, in a place called Magnesia, there was a shepherd who was herding his sheep, and his name was Magnus. He was wearing thick boots having iron nails on them. Okay, as you can see here in the figure, he was wearing very thick boots, and it had iron nails on them. So he also carried a wooden stick having a metal tip. Okay, when he reached a large black rock, he found that he couldn't move as his boots and his staff got stuck to the rod. Okay, he was not able to move. Why? Because his shoes as well as his staff, it got stuck to the rock. He dug up the earth to find a black rock which stuck iron things to it. So, and it is believed that because of Magnus of Magnesia, this boy's name was Magnus, and because of Magnus of Magnesia, the rock is called as magnetite. And some people also believe that the Chinese also knew about the properties of magnetite around the same time. That is, this is almost 4000 years ago. They also knew about a hill near River Indus which contained a stone that could attract iron. And they also discovered that a needle of magnetite, when floated on water, pointed in the north-south direction. So therefore, this magnetite was also called as lodestone. The pieces of magnetite was called as magnets. That is which we know as magnets nowadays. Now we'll move on to magnetic and non-magnetic material. So, in addition to iron, magnets also push or pull things made of steel, cobalt and nickel. Okay, so the materials which are affected by magnets are called as magnetic materials, or you can say that the materials which gets attracted by magnets are called magnetic material, and the materials which are not attracted by magnets are called as non-magnetic material. So let's find out some objects around us which are magnetic and non-magnetic. Now for example, fork, is it magnetic or non-magnetic? It is non-magnetic. Eraser is non-magnetic. Needle, since it's made of iron, it is magnetic. Then scale, thread, all these are non-magnetic. Metal cap is magnetic if it is made of iron or cobalt or nickel. Coin also gets attracted. Iron scrubs get attracted. So all these are magnetic materials. Okay, we come to natural and man-made magnets. The magnet made from lodestone are called as natural magnets. Why are they called natural magnets? Because just now I told you lodestone, it was found naturally. So that is why they are called as natural magnets. But then there are some man-made magnets. That is, man-made magnets. People have made this. It's human beings which have made this magnet. And when it was discovered that magnetic substance could be converted into magnets, they made the magnets. And man-made magnets can be either temporary magnets or permanent magnets. Temporary magnets attract magnetic materials for a short period of time. And permanent magnet will always remain magnetic. Even if they break into two pieces, अगर दो parts में वो टूट भी जाते हैं तो भी उसके दोनों part will act as a magnet. Magnets can be of different shape, as you can see here, a bar magnet, a horseshoe magnet, cylindrical magnet, a disc shaped magnet or a ball ended magnet. All these are different shapes of the magnet. Now you have to take a sewing needle and a bar magnet and rub the magnet on the needle 20 to 30 times. Okay, needle liya hai, and then after that what have you done? You have taken a bar magnet and you have rubbed it 20 to 30 times in the same direction with the same end. जिस एंड से कर रहे हो और उसी डायरेक्शन में. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम हियर, हियर टू हियर, उसके बाद लिफ्ट करोगे, अगेन हियर टू हियर, अगेन लिफ्ट हियर टू हियर, अगेन लिफ्ट. सो दिस वे यू विल कीप ऑन डूइंग एटलीस्ट 20 to 30 टाइम्स. एंड देन व्हेन यू ब्रिंग फ्यू नीडल्स, फ्यू एनी ऑफ द सेफ्टी पिन्स और स्मॉल पिन्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ दिस नीडल, it will start attracting. Now why did this happen? This happened because the needle has become a temporary magnet. Usko jab continuous tumne rub kiya, it has become a temporary magnet. Now, and you will see children that only the magnetic materials can be turned into temporary magnets. जो ऑलरेडी मैग्नेट है, नीडल इज मेड अप ऑफ आयन, सो इट कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू अ टेम्प्रेरी मैग्नेट. इट विल हैव इट्स इफेक्ट ओनली फॉर अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. थोड़ी देर के बाद ये पिंस गिर जाएंगे. ओके, सो दिस इज अ टेम्प्रेरी मैग्नेट फॉर अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. नाउ डस टर्निंग इन टू अ मैग्नेट चेंज द अपियरेंस ऑफ द नीडल? चेंज इन द अपियरेंस? वॉट यू हैव टू डू, प्लेस टू मोर नीडल्स अलॉन्ग विद द मैग्नेटिक नीडल. You will find that you can't identify the magnetic needle just by looking at them. So can you suggest a method to do so? You have to compare the power of the magnetic needle with that of the bar magnet. Which one is stronger? Magnets can have different powers. Some magnets are very, very powerful, and they are so powerful that they can be used to lift cars from the site of accidents, heavy metal pipes. All these can be used. So there are some of them are very, very powerful magnets, and some are not very powerful magnets. Okay, so I hope children that this much is clear to all of you. The rest will continue in the next class. Thank you and have a wonderful day.